There was a question on my use of the term homogeneous when I described the Dirichlet boundary conditions. So let me explain that. So the question would be something like, what are homogeneous Dirichlet boundary conditions? Here, the term, the use of the term homogeneous simply means zero. Okay, so when I say that a problem has homogeneous Dirichlet boundary conditions, what we mean is homogeneous. Sorry. Dirichlet boundary conditions implies that UH at zero, for instance, this is the setting in which I used it. Sorry, that's a little too close. UH at zero equals U zero. That's the form in which we write out our Dirichlet boundary condition in the Dirichlet-Neumann problem, for instance. This is equal to zero, right? This is what makes it homogeneous. That's what we mean by homogeneous. That's all. So once we have that, the point that I was making in the previous segment is that once we have that condition, we also have always that since we have a Dirichlet boundary condition at zero, we always know that WH at zero is equal to zero, okay? But now, with this fact that both UH and WH vanish on the Dirichlet boundary, right? This plus the fact that UH and WH both belong to H1 on omega essentially implies that the spaces are identical. SH is equal to VH. Okay, that was the condition under which we derived our last two corollaries. Okay, all right. I should probably state here that the use of the term homogeneous comes from at least in my usage, it comes from basic theory of differential equations, where differential equations where with the forcing function that is zero are referred to as homogeneous differential equations, and in fact the solution to those differential equations are called homogeneous solutions, right? Okay, we'll stop here.